one. This is kind of like,
let's complete your player info.
This is kind of like the NBA 2K my story or my player. But I already played through it once, so I already know everything that happened. It's just really good. It's better. It has the better story. The story is pretty cool. But first we need to get past actually creating him. So I'm trying to find UCLA. Travel down to the news section. Here it is. And we're gonna be what here should be. Oh wait, what number? We're gonna be the GOAT's number 23. No, we're gonna be right handed. Now our name is gonna be the best, I don't know, the best name ever. My first name. I can't show my own first name, okay. And then our last name is gonna be James, just cause LeBron James. Wait, no, I wanna be a guard, so I'm gonna put the guard's name. Thomas, because Isaiah Thomas, just the best ever player, the best player in the East right now. Except for LeBron. Christian Thomas. Yeah, that's fine. Now let's actually find Thomas. No, it's down near R. And I did R in my first one, and it was in this one, so. ST. Ah, there it is, Thomas. Whoa, what the heck? No, we're from the US, boy. Hey, we're not from Alaska. Where should we be from? I wanted to be from a cool place. Texas. Oh no, Chicago. Washington. That's it. Right here, darling. Ooh, Compton. Yes. Okay. So that's our player info. Now, our head. So,
download the game face HD.
No.
Scan yourself and get your face.
I don't want to have an ugly face. We might do head two. I like head two. Yeah, okay. Now, hair. This is good.
Your hairstyle says a lot about your look.
This hairstyle is pretty good. I this guy. Either this one or. Let's find it. Found this one earlier. This one. I think this one. I think the other one looks better on him. Let's just check the other ones. Like this one, which I don't really like on him. No. I think we might go. I think we're gonna go with the other one, the brown hair one. I'm switching. Yep. Okay, there you go. Any facial hair that actually looks good?
Clean shaven. Your path to facial hair greatness starts here.
Is there no? Oh, we're definitely gonna go. Where was it? I just saw this one. Definitely. Look at him. No, I'm not gonna go with that one though. Oh, okay, I like that one. Just a slick one. Double. One like little piece of hair.
Now it's time to
decide. Oh, this is my first video here. And we're definitely gonna play like a guard, I think.
Guard, wing, or
so
big.
Guards. I either wanna I think we're gonna be a slasher.
Let's define your style of play. This will determine
how good is his 3-point? Or does he not have 3-point? What the hell? Yeah, we're gonna slash
it. It's time to choose your player's height and weight.
Now,
every choice you make here will affect
the
player's physical capability.
I don't want to be too tall. Maybe
both good
six
and bad.
Three.
So choose wisely before you lock in.
Okay. And then we're gonna be a little skinny, skinny boy. Really skinny. Or, yeah, I think this is good right here. Cause then, yeah, yeah, cause then we're fast. Oh wait, no, what the hell did I do? So, cause I like to be fast. I like to play fast. And we got, we were pretty high. We were like 6. That's good, yeah. Okay, so continue. Player name, yes, Christian Thomas. Now let's go. And after this is going to be a cutscene, so I'll just be quiet during that. I think there's going to be a cutscene if I remember right. Ah, okay. So this is a song from the last time I played this. Okay. Now we are starting, right? Okay, I'll be quiet now.
Like millions of other kids, you dreamed of one day being in the NBA. You wanted to be a star. And someday, to rise above and become the greatest to ever play. You dreamed of being the one. But the road to stardom is never easy. There are obstacles, injuries, and disappointments. Adversity is universal. It can happen to anyone at any time. And one day, it happened to you. You went from being a guaranteed lottery pick to a kid who may never even play college ball again.
Now look, it's always bad to hear about injuries, especially to college kids, of course.
Yeah.
But Stephen A. Smith, this one is particularly disheartening because we are 2 weeks into the season and one of the top NBA prospects in the country goes down potentially with a season-ending injury, a knee injury. That's a killer.
I couldn't agree more. When I heard he was carried off the floor today, all you can do is find yourself hoping that he'll make it back. That's the bottom line. But my heart goes out to him because I didn't expect this. This is a devastating injury. It's never good to have something like this happen to you.
The team doctor broke the news. Torn ACL, sprained MCL, and a torn meniscus. Surgery was scheduled, but your game will likely never be the same. At the 2016 NBA draft, your name is still mentioned. Not as a prospect, but as a cautionary tale.
Now, there's another huge story in this year's draft. A record number of underclassmen, 30 of them, undrafted. And I hope, anyway, that this is a lesson, this serves as an example to college players. I'm not talking about the ones who are genuinely one and dones, the guys you know are going to be lottery picks. I mean the rest of them. They're not sure shots. You're not sure they're going to be lottery picks. Don't just use the college system for a year thinking you're going to bounce. It doesn't work like that.
Please.
If you don't have the talent, it doesn't work. You got to be cultivated
please,
in the system.
Please, please. There you go again with your blanket generalizations. You know how you are, oh, Max. The woe is me. Oh, my Lord. I can't take it. I just can't take it. It's a case-by-case basis. You can't just blanketly decide this should not be one and done or this should be one and done. You got to go on a case-by-case basis. Some dudes deserve to be one and done. Some people don't. It's on a case-by-case basis.
And that is my point. Thank you for making it for me. Every kid thinks they're the exception to the rule. And members of the media like Stephen A. Smith are encouraging these kids to come out early.
Look, Max, bottom line is this. You got to take this into consideration. You had two dudes. They were called the Hype Brothers. Now, you had Nick Howard. This kid had a lot of promise. What does he do? He goes to college. Very uneventful first year, no doubt. The second year, he was pretty good. Here's the problem. The NBA, it's not about pretty good. You need to be great on the collegiate level, on the prep level, in summer leagues and what have you, in order for you to get the stature that you deserve. That's the bottom line. You're pretty good ain't good enough to
That's
be that
my
stud
point.
NBA.
How That's is exactly it my point.
Let
point.
Me finish. Let me finish. There's another example. I did say the Hype Brothers. I wasn't talking about one individual. I was talking about two. What happens? One and done in a different way. 1 year, one ACL injury later, and look where he's at now. His future is clearly uncertain. So you got to take advantage of that opportunity because you never know when an injury is going to cost you everything.
Stephen A., listen to yourself. Just listen to yourself for a second. You give one argument for why a kid should come out early, a one and done situation. I can give you 30 arguments this morning alone why they should stay in school. And now you have to wonder what a kid like Nick Howard, who has given up his college eligibility, does next. What does he do next?
First of all, don't sweat the technique. The argument, or one argument, as long as it's strong enough, that's all that matters. That's number one. Number two, the Hype Brothers were something special. What they really, really need to do, and I'm going to tell you what they need to do, Mac. They need to get back to playing together. My sources are telling me the ACL injury has been completely healed. So go on a pro-am circuit. Go in summer leagues. Do what you got to do to get back on the court together to remind everybody of what you want to work. Because once you pull that off, the sky's the limit. That's what they need to do. Get back to playing ball together, because when people see what you can do as one, the other arguments don't really matter. Like I said, don't sweat the technique.
Okay, so basically throughout this whole story they're gonna have things like that, so it looks like this is like actual TV and things. And you can see the tweet from the main, from like the side characters in the back. The main characters you'll see at the bottom left, or like around the bottom left. Nick Howard, this guy that they were just talking about, they never mentioned the name because they don't know. Because they couldn't program that in it, so. yeah, interesting. Interesting? I know, unreal. So, the last one, usually, they'll have this. I'm always going to pick the one on the bottom because I really want to have packs because they'll give you cool things. Now watch, we're about to open up a pack. Babe, we got a tank top. Crazy. Examine gear now. We can equip it. Streets Road 1. See? Now we're gonna be wearing that. Easy. Ow. If I felt like it, I could open up more packs. But I don't have the levels right now. Watch. See? You need to. Once I play a little bit of games, the reason it's 5 out of 10 is because I already played this, as you know. So. Yeah. Oh, but as you go on, you'll level up, like, in that, like, right now, all the things at the top are level 1. Before, I was 74 rated, because I didn't work too much. I only worked on my 3-point shot, but after that, I didn't work on anything. So anyway, let's go. I think after the two chapters, we will be able to open up packs. But right now, we can't. Okay, so as you can see, this is our team. Every once in a while, you're going to see actual players playing with us. But usually, it'll just be like in the first, in this game, it was just a bunch of random people, except for Vince Carter and Joakim Noah and Lance Stephenson. Everyone else is just random. Anyway, we're gonna change our outfit street to Road 1, or not. Even though it's weird how what you wear works. I think I need to go into the equip section, then equip it, and then go into the game. If I do it before, then it just won't work. Or it just works online, I'm not sure.
This is New York City.
It is a cutscene, so I'll be quiet.
The original Rucker League began here in 1947. 9 years later, the tournament found a permanent home uptown at PS 156 Playground. Those early Rucker days showcased talents like Lou Alcindor, Wilt DeStilt, and Earl the Pearl. It's also where Julius Erving became the Doctor. In 1974, the park was respectfully renamed Holcomb Rucker Park in honor of the tournament founder. Now, many have influenced the growth of the Rucker since, but none more heavily than the late great Greg Marius, founder of the EBC. Many would argue that the Ruck is the birthplace of true street ball and the crossover dribble. Considering New York City's penchant for flashy guard play, there are few who can challenge that. After the legendary exploits of Rucker alumni like Rod Strickland, Rafer Austin, and Kyrie Irving, it goes without saying that getting crossed up or banged on can happen to anybody at any given moment here. It's no wonder that this unassuming uptown playground has become the most widely recognized streetball court in the world. Rucker Park, Harlem.
Okay, so before every time I play, they're gonna have a cutscene. And I'll always be quiet just so that you can hear it. Cause, I usually talk during it and it gets kind of annoying, so. I'm gonna be quiet. If you want me to do my story on my career on 2K17, I'll do that. Until I get 2K18, then I'll start doing one on that. But there you go. Hey, we finished that. Let's go. Okay. So as you see, they have this directional guard thing where it shows where you need to go. If you go that way, you'll cut him off, and then he can't go anywhere. It's easier than 2K because now you need to guess where they're going. This is pretty easy, actually. This game, I'm probably not going to pass too much because this is by far one of the easiest games there is in this game. In this mode, I mean. Oh my god. It did, well, after I say that happens, of course. Pass. Save it, now pass it. There we go! Let's dunk on it, boy! My other character I couldn't dunk on him because he was so small. So I decided to make him a small guy. Let's get it, come on. Get it, yeah, so. So basically this kid is supposed to be, if you guys don't understand the beginning of it, he's supposed to be a college player that hurt like three parts of him. Like his ACL, his MCL, and then he broke something in his knee. What's this? Let's go. And now he's trying to get, and he's not in college anymore, so now he's trying to get back to being pretty, really good. Because he was really injured. That's my man. get it. Let's go! Can't guard me. Go anyway. Ooh, Nick Howard dunked on him really good. What was? I think that was just one guy, even though it looked like two guys. Hey, let's get it. Now we're gonna go drive, dunk, or not, or just lay up. I held it because I thought he was going dunk, but he didn't. I wanna try to hit threes. I wanna become a 3-point shoot. I wanna shoot threes. I was. Oh, that was just bad timing, okay. That wasn't even my fault. Oh no, that was my fault, but. Get that. Ugh. So at the top left, you can see like my teammate grade. Like it's how well I was playing. So for now, if I'm not mistaken, because I can't see all of it, because my TV's too small. But I think I'm at 76. Oh, hit that shot. Oh, what? So wide open. Okay. Hey, if someone's going to guard him, that's okay. Yep. Put that shot. What? Bad shot selection. Okay. Yeah, wide open after free throw line. Bad shot selection. That's a contest. There we go. I thought I could hear my dog barking, yeah. Anyway. I'm cool? What's that? What the hell? Get it. Or is going up? Yeah, okay, go. Oh, I'm gonna hit him with the alley-oop. Was that even my fault? Like. I swear, if we lose this game... Hit that. Yes! Let's go! Impossible dribble, still got it. So we're playing up to 21, no. Go. What? How? No. How is that? Oh. Get me to pick. Use it and slam, let's go. We're probably gonna win this game. We'll see. I mean, it's close, but it's up to 21, so we'll probably win. Actually, every game in this is up to 21. Surprisingly, I thought in the pro-am it'd be something else, but yes. Okay, let's go. There we go. I pressed. Oh wow. Get it. Oh wow. And okay. Anyway. Double team. I'm just gonna do this so that I can. Did I not get the contest for that? Yo! Let's go! That's how you finish off a game.
Play of the game.
Of the game, that's all. The coward, okay. Oh, was it his dunk? Yeah, it was probably his dunk. Yeah, that nasty one. Actually, I think, I know I said chapter 1 only in the title if you actually read it, but I think I'm going to play chapter 2 just because it's so short, so every episode I'm going to play 2 chapters. From now on. But in the next game, this is going to be just, this is going to be a player that, that's actually really good. You'll see. Okay, so dribbling your layup. Let's see the layup real quick. I think we should work on our layup. All these, you gain a little bit of something. Like, you get someone's layup. Right now we got Derrick Rose, which he's not good, but next we're gonna get Kemba Walker, Andrew got shoes, by the way, Isaiah Thomas, Steph Curry's shoes, Russell Westbrook layup, John Wall, and Kyrie Irving. Well, we're gonna work on our lips for now, I think. I think on the next one, I think we're gonna go mid range shot, and then we're gonna go shot off the dribble, and then dunk if we can. Just because I really like the dunk. To alter her perception of me, the older you get, the more expensive lessons will be. Gotta tighten up, move a little bit more militant. Coming down your block, looking like we copped the whole dealership. Penthouse suites, but could they tell you what city? Same ones who stay down with me, gonna be up with me. See, that's the code you uphold when you know what it took to really grow to the star you are known. So when Boogers touched down, I got the Bentley waiting for him. In LA, the next time I'll probably play the four. But for now, NYC Buckets, get your show for real at the hashtag Rucker. Are the hype brothers back for real? I don't know, are they? You tell me. Okay, this one, okay. Okay, so. I might as well pick the bottom part of it because I want these packs. I don't want to pay for them. Oh, yo, we got some shorts out here. Let's go. Small minds, too bad. I give my girls a new life. You give your girls a new bag. Doing interviews with Forbes because the come up's amazing. I got a new fetish for jewelry and they spend. offensive vacations. I got the industry show. Okay, now look at who we're playing against. So we got Kevin Love on the other team. We got Nick Young on the other team. And then a bunch of other people I don't know. Then on our team, we got... what's this dude's name again? Forgot. All the way on the left, we got that dude. Then we got Blake Griffin. Just by far the best player on the Clippers now. But Chris Paul left. Then we got Matt Barnes all the way on the right. So now let's play this game. Okay, so... On the side of the screen, you see how good we are at stuff. Like, apparently speed were really good. Their team isn't really good at anything. Okay, now I'm going to take off my... Once this finish loading, I'm going to take off my mic because then there's going to be a cutscene.
Beautiful Venice Beach. A place like no other. Fit with a cast of characters and all the sun, sand, and shoreline you can handle. But Venice Beach basketball brings a completely different kind of beauty to the beach. A beauty made of long-range jumpers, meta world peace-level defense, and some of the best athletic ability in the West. And it ain't news. Since the heyday of the OG Ray Lewis dropping 50 on Michael Cooper in the 80s. Since Freedom Williams put up 75 in a college game. Since Ron Beals created the trend of street ball legends pushing the pros to their very limits under the scorching California sunshine. Long before baggy shorts and elbow sleeve became the universal uniform of choice, every guard at Venice has been a menace. And the rule here is, you reach, we teach. Teach your defense the definition of pressure, and big men, pack a lunch. It's gonna be a long day down there in the paint. Out here, the days are long, and the handles are strong. Are you ready to get busy on the beach? Venice.
Okay, well, anyway. So, on our team, you already saw who was on our team. I don't get to control the tip-off, so if any of you guys ask me why we never win it, because I don't control it. Wait, set a pick, someone. Come on, random dude that no one does. Okay, pick and roll, get it, there you go. But don't forget, this is only the demo, so I won't be able to play at the league. I know I'll just make it up to the draft, we'll see who I get drafted by, where I got drafted. At what? Yeah, I got drafted, and I'm gonna dunk on him. Let's go! Get the dunk. Oh, not. Give him a free rebound. Apparently, a dunk in the street games are a really big deal because they almost always make the top plays. Wait, what do you have, 4 points? Oh, yeah. I got that turnover. Ooh. Oh, I contested it too. Oh my God, we can't hit a jumper for our life. We need to work on that mid-range. But on a layup, we don't really need to. Oh yeah, and there's no shooting fouls here. Hit a 3-1. wide open, we can't hit a three. My god. In this game, I think it's impossible to hit a three if you have a low three-point rating. Look it up. What the hell? Yeah, we can't hit a mid-range shot either. Great. Ah, no, we're not. Okay, let's get the basket. That's fine too. Yeah, let's get it. When the full game comes out, I'll try to get it, and then I'll continue it off from where we left off. Continue it so from where we left off. Okay, that's, we contested that, let's go. Come on, hit him with the flash pass. Bang, let's go. I'm gonna pass it out, I'm gonna come. Okay, that I impacted that shot. Or not, okay. Hit him with the lit, with the alley-oop or not. I don't think it's possible for me to get an alley-oop. What low passing? I can't do it. Okay, Hunter Anderson, he's a monster. I'm about to slam on this guy. Or just lay up. That's fine too. Get it. Oh, yeah. Yo, Hunter Anderson is blocking everything. I was hyped about playing with Blake Griffin. Just don't take the wide open shot. That's fine too. Then Kevin Love is gonna dunk, of course. Oh, what? So now we're at 69. I can tell that. Oh. Skills. me being fast is a pretty good thing because then out of nowhere, like if they're on a fast break, I can block it if I can actually get to it. I could test in the shot, but no, nothing. But no, he still makes it. Cause logic. Get back on track. Maybe I have to score one. That was an assist. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. You guys rebound? That. Oh God. Why would anyone take that shot? Get it. That's my fault. Let's go, fun. I really want to score to win it back. There we go! So 64 at the end of the rating.
Play of the game.
Okay, Hunter Anderson. Oh, I think it was the rebound of my retarded drift. Yeah, it was the rebound. Yeah. For some reason, they make that such a big deal. When that happened, like he rebounds it and makes a dunk. I'm pretty sure we got 64. Yeah. Oh, wow, we got like what? 12 points.
Try my patience. It's gone. Who was left to save us? We mourn. I'm praying for my neighbors. They say that.
Okay, so now we get to upgrade it one more. We'll go upgrade a layup again because we need to become like an absolute monster at layups. I want to at least. I want to at least get our layup up to 80. Pretty exposed, Gobert, right there.
You better ready for it. I can't you feel.
Okay. Now, we're going to go open some crates. We're going to open. Since I have 40,000, and each of them are like 1,000. Yeah, something like that. We're going to open 10. So, 1. Okay. I'm gonna just keep on doing this crap. Give me something nice. No. Well, give me something good. Come on. Yes, I wanna confirm the purpose of this. Don't give me trash. Yeah, I think we're gonna use that. Oh, wait. No, actually, no, we're still gonna use that, it looks like. I think we might go use those jeans I never. These jeans right here. Wait, let me see how this looks. Oh, no, that looks bad. We need to get some nice looking pants. That sounds weird to say, but seriously, we need some. We have some cargo shorts on. Cargo pants. Okay. Oh no, that was worse than the black jeans, my god. Do these look any better? We'll just see how he looks like with these on. Actually, no, he doesn't look that bad with these. So now we can't buy any more of this because we already bought everything. We already got everything there. What level do I need to be to get this? Okay, well anyway. That's gonna be it for this episode. If you guys want to see me play NBA 2K, I'll be happy to do that, but for this episode, that's gonna be it. Goodbye, guys.